everyone, and welcome to Go Watch Movie episode 96. I'm Kelvin.
And I'm Robert.
Today, we are tackling some controversy as far as the Fast and the Furious franchise goes, but we're going hard at it. Hobbs and Shaw. Well, sorry, Fast and the Furious presents Hobbs and Shaw. Gonna be a fun, fast, not fast, but I'm just going off the movie title. Forget it. It's gonna be fun. Before we get into that, a little bit of entertainment news. Sir, have you heard about the Coming to America sequel?
I have not. This is news to me.
Coming to America Part 2 is happening. Eddie signed on. Arsenio Hall signed on. They have just added a new entry as of today, Mr. Wesley Snipes.
Really?
Yes. Are you excited for a Coming to America sequel? So long.
I
mean,
I like the first one quite a bit. I think it's a great movie. For and I think it's aged, you know, fairly well too, but I don't really see how they could do a sequel.
1988.
And make it like relevant. I don't know.
Yeah. It's going to be, tough to follow.
It's just like they're just going to make fun of themselves in the last movie or something, as opposed to, because the first one, besides being a comedy, it had some serious, you know, tender moments, kind of, sort of. Like, it was halfway taking itself seriously as well as being a comedy. So this, I don't know what they, I mean, I don't know.
One of Samuel L. Jackson's first movies. Like, it's...
I just don't see it.
The royal penis is clean, Your Highness.
How do you top that?
Moving on to Disney. So Disney put out that... they finally put out the prices for their upcoming Disney Plus platform. And it's pretty reasonable, I must say. They put out a bundle package deal. Disney Plus, Hulu, and ESPN Plus, all for $12.99, which is insane. That matches Netflix's price and is $2 less than HBO Now and Max are going to be. And less than I'm paying now for just Hulu. So that is pretty awesome. Disney Plus alone is $6.99. So yeah, they're definitely competing with as far as prices goes. And they're going to have quite a few films at lunch. Have they swayed you yet, sir?
No, I'm slow. I'm always slow. I'm always like the last one. Like, get Wi-Fi. What do I need Wi-Fi for? You know, then finally got some Wi-Fi. Like, oh, that's why I need it. So, yeah, I'm slow, but maybe I'll get there. We'll see.
Nothing wrong with that. It's it's
part of being old.
And there's so many out now, you know, there's just like... I mean, there's going to be that, the HBO Max, the HBO Now, Netflix, all the other ones. It's I don't know if we sound like old people. You guys shut up. last but not least, Event Horizon. Remember that spooky fucking movie?
Oh, I love that movie. Such an underrated movie.
Me too, but it scares the hell out of me. but Amazon has a series of Event Horizon in development.
Yeah, I mean, the only thing that I did not like about Event Horizon is that we didn't get the originally gory, like, version that they wanted to give us. We got the, you know, edited one.
Yes.
So now if it's become a series. Is that original
floating around somewhere?
I don't know for sure. I've seen some stuff on YouTube and whatnot talking about it, but yeah, we didn't get what we should have got. I mean, what we could have got, which really, really would have messed people up. So I feel like putting it in show version isn't going to quite do what, you know, that justice.
A lot of these networks though are trying to outdo each other in that facet.
I think it's going to be watered down though. If it's on, I don't know. I just don't feel like they're going to give it to us the way it should be.
You're probably right.
But I mean, it's still cool though that we're getting the show for that, because I think that's an underrated movie that's pretty darn good.
Like, extremely underrated. And this is probably going to be blasphemous, but it has that same tension as the original Alien. Like, it's terrifying.
Yeah, so much going for it. It's ridiculous.
Yes.
So if y'all haven't seen that one, I said y'all, go ahead and watch it.
That's for y'all southern states down there. You all. But that will bring us to trailers. You first or me, sir?
I think I went first last time. You go ahead.
Gonna go with the film 1917. Mm-hmm. This is a war film by Sam Mendes, the same fellow who brought us, just blanked on that last James Bond movie name. But he brought us that. And the war film, Benedict Cumberbatch is going to be in it. Apparently, someone's brother and an entire platoon of, I think, 1,600, maybe 16,000 are going into a war zone. They're about to engage the enemy, but it turns out that it's a trap. They have to, one brother and his friend, another soldier, have to go and stop these people from going into this trap before they are all slaughtered, and it turns the tide of the war forever. Looks very, very beautiful, even in just trailer form. That is mine, sir. Have you seen that one?
I have not. I'm going to check it out, though.
Yeah, that's pretty good.
All right, so...
But it is a war movie. I know how you feel about war movies.
I know. I was about to say something about that. I was like, I'll let it go. But yeah, it's a war. You're really going to have to pull me in for that one, but I'm going to check it out and see what's going on. All right, so mine, you know how I like the movie Witch. I think I've mentioned it several times. I just think it's... pretty sweet little movie. I like the atmosphere. So the director of which is coming, has another movie coming out soon called The Lighthouse. Hmm. And I am pretty excited about this one. It's in black and white, which kind of piques my interest right there. It's got William Dafoe.
Yes.
And Robert Patterson.
I haven't gotten around to watching this yet.
Oh, you need to watch this. Okay. It is a delight.
So the Green Goblin and Batman are together.
Yes. So it's kind of trying to put it into words. It's kind of hard because I struggle with this every time. But basically, you're watching two guys stuck in a lighthouse, drinking way too much and tripping out somehow, to the point where they don't know how long they've been in the lighthouse. You don't know if they're alive or dead, or if they're ghosts, or if they're being tortured, or there's something else going on. There must be, because the trailer just looks insane. It's them just running around, being crazy, acting their butts off. There's some crazy imagery of just, you know, all kinds of trippy stuff, and you're just, and then it's in black and white, so it has a different feel to it, and it just looks spectacular. I can't wait to see this movie. It's been a while since I watched something. I get excited because my imagination starts going crazy, like, what is this about? So The Lighthouse, definitely.
Damn. Yeah, I need to watch that one. I saw the thumbnail and I read those two names, and despite people hating the fact that he's going to be Batman, everything else I've seen other than Twilight, Robert Pattinson in, he's actually a decent actor. Mm-hmm. So I'm going to check that one out as soon as we are done here. So that will bring us to Hobbs and Shaw. I want to get this right. The Fast and the Furious presents Hobbs and Shaw. Watchbot, if you would not mind.
Ever since hulking lawman Hobbs Johnson, a loyal agent of America's diplomatic security service, and lawless outcast Shaw Statham, a former British military elite operative, first faced off in 2015's Furious 7, the duo have swapped smack talk and body blows as they've tried to take each other down. But when cyber-genetically enhanced anarchist Brixton Idris Elba gains control of an insidious bio-threat that could alter humanity forever, and bests a brilliant and fearless rogue MI6 agent, the crown's Vanessa Kirby, who just happens to be Shaw's sister, these two sworn enemies will have to partner up to bring down the only guy who might be badder than themselves. It stars Dwayne Johnson, Jason Statham, Idris Elba and Vanessa Kirby.
Thank you, Watchbot. Before we get right into Hobbs and Shaw, though, there's just a little something that we need to talk about. Mr. Tyrese. Tyrese is part of the Fast and the Furious franchise. Uh-huh. He's, you know, the comedic relief, to say the least. And I hate to just narrow him down to that, but, you know, that's kind of what he is in those movies. He reignited the beef of The Rock and him, because he originally got mad, upset when The Rock decided to split the franchise, or spin off the franchise, I have to say, and didn't include others. And, you know, there was alleged beef between The Rock and Vin Diesel, and those two really never said anything about each other. But Tyrese came out and publicly even went at The Rock, and The Rock went at him a little bit. Well, he came out Monday, I believe it was, and he said this on Instagram: "I have to show my respects for one thing. He tried." Gibson wrote, "Calling the box office numbers for Hobbs and Saw not a win. Folks called me a hater and attacked me for speaking out. Breaking up the family clearly doesn't have the value that one would assume it does. You know what? Maybe, just maybe, The Rock and his crew will come dance with us again for Fast 10. We can all hug it out and get back to giving the true fans who have supported the franchise for 20 years what they want. Not hating, just pointing out the facts." Then he went on to say, "It only made $60 million its first week, opening week here in America, $120 million internationally. That's, you know, $180 million on a $2 million budget." So, yeah.
How much of a million budget?
$200 million.
$200 million. Okay.
It was 20 shy of re-getting its budget back. So technically, it's a quote unquote flop. Mm-hmm. Because it didn't, you know, make its budget back. So technically he's not lying, but it is the number one movie currently in America. So I don't know. I just found that interesting that he chose to do that. And of course, he also pointed out that The Rock's not hurting. The Rock has 17 franchises, is ready to go under his belt, you know. Uh-huh. But he said it's not hate. He just pointed out the facts. It's hate.
Yeah, it pretty much is.
Clearly.
That's okay.
Yeah, it happens.
You're always going to hit the person on top, even exactly. though, whether they deserve to be there or not.
Yeah. Was that a shot? Let's get into Hobbs and Shaw. WatchBot has already introduced it. Let's get into these characters real quick. I got their bios up here. Luke Hobbs showed up in Fast 5, you know, as a big cop hunting the Toretto gang, moved on into Fast 6, Fast 7, and The Fate of the Furious. He's not going to be in Fast 9 because he was because of this spinoff here. But yeah, he eventually hunted down the gang, caught the gang, realized the gang about all about family, and joined the gang and became part of that family, as Tyrese put it. Deckard Shaw, on the other hand, first showed up as in a cameo at the very end of Fast 6. He was the big bad, being set up as the big bad. And supposedly he was the guy who killed the guy in Tokyo Drift. Fast 7, he was still kind of the big bad. And The Fate of the Furious, him and The Rock kind of started their little back and forth bond as they got locked up together. And that brings us to Hobbs and Shaw. I'm going to start by saying I love the contrast that they start with in this movie between these two. I thought that was fantastic. You know, they show them a split screen side by side. Right. The Rock is kind of this rough and tumbled guy.
Raw eggs.
Which I think has been proven to be bad for you. I don't know. And then you have the complete opposite, James Bondish Shaw. Attired James Bond, I guess. But some people could say. What did you think of this film, Robert?
Just the whole thing overall?
Just to get us started. Just,
okay, so let me, first of all, I got a couple things I got to say. I'm not a Fast and the Furious fan. So I'm looking at this from a non-fan perspective. I do think the first movie is pretty cool. I do like Vin Diesel in it.
Yes.
And Paul Walker. I think they did a fantastic job in for the type of movie that it is. Second thing, I used to love action movies to the point where I was like, oh man, I can't wait to see the next action movie because I just wanted to see those explosions, the fights. And then I got a little bit older and I started expecting more out of movies. Mm-hmm. I expected a little bit more depth, a little more just uniqueness, a little flavor, a little story. I mean, something to set them apart from just, you know, another movie with explosions.
Movie, yeah. And a Michael Bay film.
Yeah. And then we get to this one and I sat through the entire movie feeling like, why did I ever like action movies?
Uh-oh.
Yeah, I thought, I'm not saying this movie is crap, but it kind of smells of, I mean, it's kind of blatantly just one action movie, you know, thing that you expect in every action movie to the next.
Yes.
And I just, I can't say this is the movie for me.
Yes,
but I admit
did you have fun? There was
probably that off and on, but there was like a 20-year-old me that probably would have liked this a lot more.
Yes,
but like I said, now that I've matured a little, and I expect, and there were some fun moments. Don't get me wrong, there were some cameos in this.
Yeah,
that were almost entertaining if they didn't play themselves, and then. It just, I don't know. There's a lot of it that just makes me not like the movie. I'm sorry. Gotcha. So for all the Fast and the Furious fans, maybe if you're a Fast and the Furious fans, maybe you don't like this movie either. I don't know.
Yeah, I got to tell you, I don't think that they're as excited about. I think they are side with Tyrese and saying this is a bit disrespectful by not including the family, you know.
I understand that, but I'm sorry to Tyrese. I'm a nobody compared to you, but I don't want to see you in another movie either. So it doesn't really matter if the family's in there or not. There's the thing that's magic about the first Fast and the Furious was basically Vin Diesel and Paul Walker.
Yep.
I mean, mainly Vin Diesel. But I'm just saying, I mean, I'm being honest. So hate my opinion if you want to. It's fine. But yeah, Vin Diesel, first Fast and the Furious, the only reason why I even watched the franchise anyway.
I have to say, I am not, I'm also not the biggest Fast fan. I'm not a big car guy. Yeah, they're nice looking. They go fast. And they do some amazing stunts. I did sit and watch every single Fast and Furious a while back. So I'm familiar with what goes on, and this is pretty par for the course. This just without all eight.
Yeah, it kind of morphed like from that first movie, and this, and no disrespect to Paul Walker.
Yeah,
I mean, please don't take that the wrong way, but after that first movie, it definitely morphed into something. Like, just, I don't want to say ridiculous. It's like they just pumped it full of like testosterone and like cotton candy or something. You know what I mean? It just became something else. And then it became this action just blow up. And this is what this movie is. It's like you take all that and you accumulate it and then you poof. This movie didn't even need to have Fast and the Furious in the front of it.
No.
It could have just been called something else.
Yeah.
They didn't play characters that even felt like Fast and the Furious, or they just felt like they were playing the same characters they always play.
Yeah, it for sure did not. I think they should have made their own buddy cop movie instead of trying to leech off. That
would have made much more sense. Yeah. It would have made, I think they should have, yeah, I mean, it should have been something else. They could have rebranded this and made it actually awesome to an extent.
Because we didn't need the connection, especially since they're not in the movie, and like neither one of these two are the main characters of those movies. Mm-hmm. We did not need that connection.
We understand how powerful a buildup can be from the Marvel movies. Yes, you could have an amazing buildup and then end up with something insane. But this, I mean, there was no buildup. I mean, you didn't need those previous movies to show, because they did it in the beginning of the movie. They showed how these two people were completely different, yet the same, and how they needed to work together. You didn't need the other movies. So I mean, they could have made something completely original that didn't associate itself with Fast and the Furious and then maybe been a little more successful.
It is weird, now that you say that, like how, because part one, Paul Walker was like a beat cop or a detective trying to infiltrate this street level gang.
It was a movie with Patrick Swayze and Keanu Reeves. It was that. Point Break. It was Point Break.
Which is redone on Netflix, by the way. But suddenly it became like the fucking every higher branch of the world, like CIA, MI6, wanted this specific gang to do all their missions for them.
It got ridiculous.
But we digress. This is Hobbs and Shaw. I guess it is part of Fast and Furious, so it makes sense that we talk about it. But I have to say, having watched set through all of the other ones, I kind of expected the, you know, quote unquote action that they threw at me. And it had my brand of comedy. I like the corny comedy because it definitely was corny. I'm not going to deny that. Some of the dialogue was a bit unneeded and just,
there were some long drawn out moments where they were arguing with each other that I wish that just were not in the movie.
Yeah, because they're not, they're like, the first time it was funny, but then they do it 8 more times.
I didn't even like the first time. It's like it's just your face. I mean, I felt like that was like from other movies, like Step Brothers, like they did the whole face thing, like, it's your face, I don't like your face. And I just felt like they were,
it's
taking
your voice, it's your nasally Harry Potter.
And it was too much of just The Rock wanting to show off that he's The Rock, or I'm sorry, I don't know if he even goes by The Rock anymore, Dwayne. He's like, when he's talking about, yeah, I'm flexing my brain and this giant muscle that happened to be right here in the shot too. It's like, is that, I mean, okay, we get it. We already know you're huge in more ways than one. It doesn't matter.
Yeah.
I mean, you give me something else, like, it surprised me. That would be amazing. If you surprised me, then I would be like, holy crap, this guy is awesome, because he went above and beyond and then outside the box. But if you just stay in the box and show me your muscle, I'm just going to get bored of it.
Hey, let's talk about The Rock a little bit more. What did you think of Hobbs in this one? Did you, like, did he appeal to you a bit?
No, not at all. I mean, I don't know. I mean, they tried to pump him up, the whole family thing, you know, by adding it. I don't know when the daughter was introduced, if it was in previous movies or not. I have no clue because I don't watch them. But the daughter, I mean, it was a nice touch, but again, it was just something to show who he was throughout the movie, that he was this family connected person.
Yes.
But it didn't drive with me, because there wasn't enough of it. Because then he like cut off his family in Samoa. It's like, so you're a family guy, but you cut off your other side of your family. Mm-hmm. And then we get to finally find out why. And then it's a complete letdown, because you turned your dad in. It's like, I mean, somebody should have turned you in for stepping out on your family. And so it's like, it just, I don't know. It just didn't do it for me. And the same, but equally, Jason's character, Shaw. I mean, Shaw, just didn't, same thing.
So like, I gotta say, he as a villain, he was fantastic for the last 2.5 Fast movies. I thought he was great as their adversary, because he had the, of course, the driving skills from Transporter and Tyler Jobs, which they give a nod to a Tyler Jobs in this movie, which I liked. But I thought he was great. He's a great fit there. But to turn that character into a willing participant, good guy, and clean up his backstory, you know, kind of threw me off a bit, because I liked him as a bad guy.
Yeah, and he had his own family thing that they were trying to build with the mom and Jill and then the sister. And again, it just fell flat on me. It just didn't seem believable. It seemed like they were just, we got to write this in so that it makes sense. And it didn't make sense. It just seemed like you wrote it in. But that's fine. I mean, I get it. It's not supposed to be this deep thinking movie that I'm, you know, wanting nowadays. It's just hey, I'm going to throw some explosions at you and a couple karate kicks.
Yep.
But yeah, that's all I got from it. Couple karate kicks. The karate kicks were cool, but oh, we're missing the best part of the movie. We are missing the best part of the movie. That's Idris.
Yes, I was hoping you brought that up. He is the shining star in this movie, because where everyone else is playing it like it's a jokey buddy cop movie, he's like, no, I'm a real badass villain. I'm a
black Superman. Why does a black Superman have to be bad?
Not sure. But yeah, it was awesome. Every aspect of, I like the introduction of that company, which name I can't think of right now. Ethan's.
I don't know.
But yeah, he was a super soldier created by them after apparently being executed by Shaw, Jason Statham's character. Spoilers. And yeah, the fight scenes with him, his Transformer-like motorcycle.
Yeah, they even threw some Transformer-like sounds in there too, which kind of bothered me. I'm like, we're not watching a Michael Bay film, are we?
Some of those bikes, like, were just doing Speed Racer moves. Mm-hmm. stars and applause. Yeah, it's just insane. Well,
but you see the best part of it in the trailer. If you saw the trailer when he like basically gets pulled underneath the truck by the bike, you've already seen the best parts of it. So
that literally was that best part. Yeah, you're right. But I tell you what, I'm in love Vanessa Kirby. That British accent, those eyes. I'm not gonna say her show name, her movie name, because that's my mom's name. That's just creepy. but Vanessa Kirby.
Yeah, she was okay.
Yeah, I mean, I was just talking about looks. Yeah, her, she
just reduce it to that. It's an action film with action. Let's not worry about
it. I like that they didn't like degrade her at all. Like she could hang with the boys.
They put her in a movie with Dwayne and Jason.
He did kind of make her look like a toothpick, because when he was fighting that fight scene with her, she gets him that leg lock. She's like, "All right, now you're gonna go to sleep. Like you're gonna attempt to do a British accent." And then he just kind of one hand picks her up.
It was too much. It was too much to show how good he is and then how weak everybody else is.
So apparently, I don't know if you heard this rumor, and it could be just rumor, but it was flying around all over the internet. Apparently, Dwayne Johnson and Jason Statham both have clauses in their contract that they can never lose a fight.
They kind of do against Idris, though. So, but maybe not in the end, which
I was able to cut my brain off and kind of have fun with this coast along with
it. I tried to, but when it's so obvious that it's, I apologize when I say stuff like this, but when it's so obvious that it's crap, then it's hard to shut it off because I keep wanting to like give it more weight than what it deserves.
Yeah, I hear.
Because I'm remembering the first one. Mm. You know, I don't have as much background to go on, so I'm just remembering the like what I felt like the message was from that first one, and then I'm trying to apply it to this, and then all I'm getting is just action buffoonery.
And it pretty much that's this. Like I said, this is kind of par for the course from part three on, even part two. Like this is kind of like over the top stunts.
Part being two able to awesome, yeah.
Being able to pull a helicopter with a chain and
yeah, that scene was just too much. And then all the people supposedly were able to catch up and just link vehicles, and they just had the perfect little setup for the linking of the vehicles.
And like some of them were just like connecting, like the car is just through hooks and they connect perfectly. I gotta tell you though, as soon as this movie turned into Home Alone, I was completely out the rest of the way. Like I was already 1 foot in, but when they go to Samoa and we gotta set up the island so that we have booby traps like fucking Macaulay Culkin, I was like, okay, I'm out. You lost me. I did. We touched on earlier a little bit though. The cameos. I enjoyed the cameos. I am a massive Kevin Hart fan, and Ron Reynolds is hilarious.
He kind of plays himself though.
That's who he is. Yeah, he has. I don't think he has any other range, honestly. And I know that sounds bad, but I just don't think he can do anything else.
He was funny though. I'll give him that. It was a treat.
He's hilarious. But that sparked a conversation on Instagram. The writer of Deadpool reached out to The Rock and said, "Dearest at The Rock, based on reports of outstanding chemistry between you and a familiar friend," this is before people saw it, they didn't know about the cameo. They still might not if you haven't seen it yet. Sorry, spoilers. "I believe the next logical step is for you to join the Marvel Universe as Garrison Kane in a future Deadpool installment." So The Rock has officially been invited over into the Marvel universe, specifically Deadpool Lane. And of course The Rock responded back. He's completely up for that, 100%. I don't know if that would be a conflict of interest because he is playing DC. Black Adam here soon. But What did you think of their chemistry? Did you enjoy him and The Rock?
I thought it was more Ryan, you know, Ryan than anybody. I didn't think The Rock brought any chemistry to the... That mean to say? Like, I don't think he.
I'm getting a Brad Pitt vibe here.
No, there's no Brad Pitt vibe. Let me get something straight. Dwayne Johnson is one of the hardest working people He is ridiculous. He just works and works and works, and he strives for excellence. I just don't prefer his particular style of excellence.
Gotcha. I enjoyed that scene with him at the table with The Rock and his daughter.
But it's all about the other guy, though. It's not about him.
Yeah, it is. He's just playing off of Ryan for sure. And then my buddy Kevin Hart, who I did not expect. The Ryan Reynolds one was spoiled for me, but Kevin, I did not expect to just pop out as the tiniest air marshal ever. Mm-hmm. the upside.
Yep.
Was a kind of a different role for him. So he has a little range, but yeah, I thought that was funny. Did you like that one at all?
I liked the other one better, but yeah, he was okay. It was nice to see somebody else in there besides just, you know, Dwayne and Jason, but
yeah. And they're buddies too. So it's only logical that he tosses them in there. We'll see if Kevin returns a favor in his next movie. Not that The Rock needs it, but yep. Which it may be Jumanji, I think, their next movie. So they may not need to return that favor, but yeah, I thought those little things were fun peppered in there, but like I said, I can't do, because Skyfall almost lost me the same way. Skyfall at the very end of it has a Home Alone sequence where 007 goes back home and to his original place where he was adopted and sets up booby traps and shit. Like, what are you doing? And I got that same vibe when they went to, which I said in the trailer. And
I understand why he did the whole Samoan thing.
Yeah, I'm not disrespecting his culture at all.
And I actually knew a guy from Samoa. His name was Samu, and he was like one of the most awesome people. He was not that big, but he was a decent sized man. He was awesome, absolutely awesome. But I mean, the way they used it, I felt like they made every Samoan look like this like almost like a junkyard, like. I don't want to say junkyard dog because that's just the wrong thing that that's popping into my head. But
he was
just
an awesome wrestler.
He was an awesome wrestler, but it's just they made everybody look the same. And just the story, it's like they almost stereotyped him into this, like, ugh. And I just don't like the way they, man, for all I know, that's what it's like over there. I don't know. I've never been to like Samoa, but.
There had to be, though, a better solution.
To get
off the grid, like, and then to have his brother, who is a car auto mechanic, the best. Okay, I'll give him that. He's the best, you know, Hobbs. I get it, but this is a fucking device created by a super genius to remove a virus. Like, that's very specific. Ask for this very specific device that seemingly is one of a kind. Your brother can fucking fix it, who's the best auto mechanic. Get the fuck out of here.
Yeah, well, he's a smart guy. He reversed technology the heck out of that thing, but still, it was like,
The last fight scene, I enjoyed the effects during it. But like the rain punches, I like that. But I did not like the way Brixton went down. That did not make me happy. go on, sir.
Nope, it's all good. It's just none of that was good for me.
Uh-oh.
Just none of it just worked. It just seemed bad. Like, and I'm sure whoever wrote it, I mean, people who wrote it worked their butts off. And,
yeah,
you know, it was a good piece of work for him. But for me, it was just
of the director of the Bad Company? Like, they want to hint towards more, apparently.
Yeah, it's like, I understand them wanting to make more movies. But I think they should take a step back and then maybe, I don't know. I don't think they should listen to me. I mean, I think they should listen to the money that's being put in their pockets and decide then what direction they want to go in. But I just don't think it brought anything. to just the movies in general.
I think they may have to, if this doesn't, if this isn't number one again next week, they may have to take a step back because they have a lot of money to, because I mean, those Fast and the Furious movies at this point make, you know, close to 400 million the first when they first come out. And I don't know if they were expecting this to do the same without all the rest of the crew, but
probably.
Yeah.
The best, like I said, the best thing about it for me was Idris Elba. And I think he did a great job as a villain. Mm-hmm. I think the character they made up was awesome. I think it was a little over the top. Like, it wasn't really believable in that universe to a point. But still, I mean, like I said, this should have been named something else. It should have
because been. Knowing that tech exists in the Fast and the Furious universe kind of changes things.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
Let's get to the Rotten Tomatoes of it all.
Surprisingly good. I mean,
let's see. Oh, shit. Yeah, it's surprisingly 67% good. Tomato meter, 89%.
Yes. People like this movie.
God damn.
I am just not one of those people. I'm not saying it's bad. I'm just saying it just wasn't for me. I just, like I said, like a 20-year-old me would have loved this. Went right up his alley. But I mean, now, not so much. I need a little bit more from my movies.
I hear you. Well, let's get to our ratings here. Go watch or not, sir. Sounds like I know.
It's a no. It's, but again, like I said, not for like a 20-year-old me, maybe, yeah. But for me now, no, absolutely not. Why did I ever go? I wanted to see Idris Elba. That was basically it.
I'm gonna go ahead and say, for those action movie junkies out there, this is gonna deliver for you. Go watch from me, just on the action movie and comedic parts, because the cameos are awesome. The Rock and Jason Statham's banter is also awesome. And Vanessa Kirby, you can marry me now if you want to. So go watch for me for those parts, for those reasons. Other than that, I don't know if there's anything else to say about this one.
Not really. I hope we don't get another. I'm just going to go ahead and say it. Not hold back, because I don't want to see another one.
Yeah, like I said, they're going to have to really do well this upcoming weekend.
And I probably wouldn't feel that way if they had rebranded it. And then added a little extra something to make it more sense to me. Like, and they would, if they would have taken out the little girl and the family thing and just made it a little more hard, a little rougher. Had him play somebody different. Mm-hmm. I'm the family guy who kicks butt and has big muscles and everybody likes. He even makes fun of himself about it, like in the movie. He's like, everybody likes me. Not everybody.
It does go against both of their characters, because Hobbs is the established characters in the Fast and the Furious mm-hmm. universe. Hobbs is a loner for sure in the Fast and the Furious movies. He's all about the job. Nothing else really matters to him. And Shaw is pretty much a cutthroat thief who only thinks about himself. So it's kind of, I mean, if you think about it, Hobbs is like the worst person ever to put his family in this horrible, because if she didn't, if the Shaws didn't think about that glove fix, mm-hmm. his family would have been mowed the fuck down. There would have been no stopping them from mowing them the fuck down. And I hated everything on the island. I fucking hate it. Like I said, I was just out. But I hated the fact that even the helicopter and truck guns were affected by this hack. Mm-hmm. Like, they couldn't shoot the helicopter guns until, oh, the guns are active again. okay, now let's blast him with the helmet. Like, why? Why is that part of the... I don't know.
But, yeah, I don't know. I think there was two big action stars in the movie together, and I think it just, for me, I'm over that. I'm going to have to go back and watch Tango and Cash from back in the day.
I have high feelings about that movie.
Yeah, so do I. But now, after seeing this, I want to go back and watch it to see if I still have the same feelings or if I think it's crap now. Maybe I've changed.
One of my favorites, and it's technically not a buddy cop because one of them wasn't a cop, but Die Hard with a Vengeance. I love it. Mm. I love the chemistry between Bruce Willis and Samuel Jackson.
That works, though.
That was great.
There's something else going on. That just works.
Yeah.
Tango and Cash is another situation.
Yeah, I may have to do that too. We have to revisit Tango and Cash.
See if it still stands up.
But where you can find us, you can find us at gowatchamovie.com. All the stories are on there. I'll try and get the trailers up there. I watched the Lighthouse one because I really want to see that trailer. The podcast is there. All the news articles we talked about are there. I added a new section, TV show recaps. I recapped the entire season of Netflix's Another Life is up there. So if you've been on the fence about that, all 10 episodes are recapped on the site. Check that out. And anywhere a podcast can be played, like us on Facebook and Twitter and Instagram, sure, and all that stuff. Other than that, that is the Fast and the Furious presents Hobbs and Shaw, episode 96 of Go Watch a Movie. I'm Kelvin.
And I'm Robert.
Go watch a movie. It's your nasally voice and your Harry Potter face.